This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there, welcome to episode 3, Solving Linear Equalities. In this episode, we'll learn how to solve an equation that doesn't just have an equal sign, it has a greater than or less than sign, and we'll learn how to graph the solution set to it. Let's get started. So in this problem, I've given you negative 2 times x minus 2 is greater than or equal to 10 plus 2 times the quantity 4x plus 2. It looks like a big mess to begin with. So the first step I recommend is to try to distribute anything that you can distribute. That's going to make the terms easier to move. We'll start by distributing the negative 2 by x minus 2. Well, negative 2 times x is negative 2x. Negative 2 times negative 2 makes positive 4. Greater than or equal to 10, and here we have another term to distribute. We have 2 times 4x and 2 times 2. We can distribute this. 2 times 4x gives us 8x. 2 times positive 2 gives us positive 4. Now we have 5 terms rather than 3, but they are easier to move. The next thing we should do in step 2 is to move any terms that contain x over to the left side. Well, here's a term that contains x, but it's already on the left. Here's another term that contains x. We can move that over to the left. Since it's positive 8x, we'll just subtract 8x, and we have to do that to the other side as well. Well, negative 2x minus 8x gives us negative 10x. Plus 4 is still there. Greater than or equal to is still there. On the right side, the 10 is also still there. The positive 8 and the negative 8 cancel out, and then the plus 4 is still there. That takes care of the x terms. Now in step 3, we're going to move any terms that do not contain x over to the right side. Well, write this in blue. Well, this positive 4 doesn't have x. We can move that to the right side. In order to move that, we'll just subtract 4. And we'll do that to the right side as well. The 10 plus 4 that we already have is already on the right. We can leave that as is. So now we have minus 10x on the left. Plus 4 and minus 4 cancel out, so we don't write anything else. The greater than or equal to is still there. On the right side, the 10 is still here. And the plus 4 and minus 4, it just so happens, also cancel out, leaving us with negative 10x is greater than or equal to 10. Now we divide by the number that's in front of x. Divide both sides by negative 10. Now this is a little different from what you're used to, because the number that we're dividing by is negative. And in an inequality problem, that means you have to change the inequality sign. So it will no longer be greater than or equal to. Since we divided by a negative, it changes to less than or equal to. Now that the sign is out of the way, though, we just worry about the numbers. We have negative 10 divided by negative 10. That cancels out, leaving us with just the x on the left side. On the right side, we have 10 divided by negative 10, which gives us negative 1. So our solution to the inequality is x is less than or equal to 1. This means that any number that is less than or equal to negative 1 is a correct answer. Now this may be kind of difficult to show, so let's try to graph this on a number line. we're going to begin by drawing a number line, and we're going to label the number that we ended up with on the line. Now, we ended up with negative 1. I'll just put a little mark right there on negative 1. Now, we check to see if the inequality sign has an equal to. If you have a sign that has an equal to, either less than or equal to, or greater than or equal to, we're going to label the point that we found with a filled-in dot. However, if it just said less than or greater than without the equal to, we're going to use an open circle. Now, our answer does have the equal to, so we're going to draw a big red dot right on top of that number. After that, you check to see if it says less than or whether it says greater than. Now, if you have a less than sign or less than or equal to sign, we're going to draw an arrow toward any numbers that are less than negative 1. That's the numbers over here. Big red arrow right there. If it had said greater than or greater than or equal to, we would draw the arrows toward the right side, toward the numbers that are greater than negative 1. But in the end, this picture right here with the number line, the closed dot, and the arrow pointing left will be your final answer. The answer is any number that is less than or equal to negative 1. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you again next episode.